Pirates.
Arr!
The word conjures images of rum-swilling swashbucklers in the Caribbean, like Jack Sparrow. But the pirates I study were more like Ching-yin. In the West, pirates were the enemies of all. Any country had the right to take action against them. In the legal code of the Qing dynasty, however, piracy was considered like any other crime and solely within its jurisdiction. These differences came to a head in the mid-19th century. My thesis argues that this conflict produced a system of cooperation and compromise between the British and Qing empires against the common problem of piracy. The British colonization of Hong Kong in 1841 introduced a foreign jurisdiction to China. From Hong Kong, British authorities imposed their international and maritime law off the China coast. This law was enforced by the muscle of the Royal Navy, which allowed the British to dominate the world's oceans for much of the 19th century. The British considered themselves justified in committing violence against Chinese pirates. They even subjected some to trial by British courts in Hong Kong, sentencing them to death. Poor Ching-yin here is but one example. The trial and execution of Chinese subjects by British tribunals violated Qing sovereignty. However, local Chinese officials struggled to suppress piracy. They saw British actions as an effective way of dealing with pirates, despite its questionable legality. But the Hong Kong criminal justice system proved incapable of processing the hundreds of pirates captured by the Royal Navy. What could be done against this common menace? As British and Qing officials struggled to deal with the problem of piracy, an informal system of cooperation emerged. Chinese officials, more familiar with local geography, would report pirates to British authorities. The British would send a gunboat, accompanied by a Chinese officer, to deal with the problem. The pirates were usually sent to Chinese courts for trial. This system of cooperation was responsible for some of the most impressive naval victories of the 19th century. Some engagements resulted in thousands of casualties for Chinese pirates. This Sino-British cooperation required compromise. By cooperating with the British, the Chinese sanctioned foreign violence against their own subjects. By handing pirates to courts in China, the British ceded jurisdiction over piracy to the Chinese. Through these interactions, the Chinese contributed to the development of international law in a period dominated by Western imperialism. As China grows increasingly strident in its nationalism, and post-Brexit Britain seeks to re-engage with the world on its own terms, my thesis suggests that cooperation and compromise are more effective means of dealing with common problems than force and bluster.